Simon & Schuster Audio presents Otto Normal's Monsterton, The Disappearance of White Pine Beach by Danielle McKechnie and Simona Strada. Performed by Danielle McKechnie. For Birdie and Maud. Prologue. A young girl made her way through a dense forest. She didn't walk, she didn't run. She bounded over enormous roots the size of boulders. She caught her breath a few more times, mid-leap to scan her surroundings. Just a few more hurdles before she would be home, inside her treehouse, safe and sound. Or as safe as one could be inside a forest like Belcarra. Her dewy black feathered arms trailed through the mist that rested above the ground. It was as if the clouds didn't know they were supposed to be in the sky. That's where they always were. Some would say the forest was cursed, but she wouldn't know. The only one she spoke to these days was herself. She hummed quietly to calm her nerves and heard a flock of morning fellows join her melody. That's weird. The small birds usually flew only during the day and hardly ever over Belcarra. They're just little birds, she reminded herself. They're not coming in. For as long as she was alive, nothing came into Belcarra that didn't already live there. Nothing came in, and nothing came out. In fact, as far as she knew, the last intruder was her. There were many mysterious and dangerous creatures that lived within the forest. But she was concerned with only two types of creatures. Lost Strix, like herself, wicked, winged beasts that appeared more human than they did bird, and the Belcarra Keeper. The Keeper was the forest's guard. He was a mountainous ghoul, dressed head to toe in black metal, who mindlessly followed the untold rules of the land. And the young Strix with broken wings knew well enough to keep her distance. She had already survived through his wake of destruction once. There was no need to tempt fate twice. The girl tracked the morning fellow's flight. They were headed toward the towering wall of black fog that sat atop the ocean's waves and extended as far as the eye could see. She thought about Corey, the only Strix she ever trusted. She wished that he was running and bounding by her side. She imagined him flying above her, setting their pace with his stormy, blackened eyes locked onto the path ahead. He found her not long after the accident that broke her wings. She had been abandoned and survived off beady bugs and water from a nearby lake when she was 3 years old, only 8 years ago. Corey helped build her treehouse at the tip of the tallest pine tree in Belcarra, a vantage point that allowed her to always be aware of the Keeper's whereabouts. He lived there with her for a long time and brought her food. He cared for her as a father would. She had a mother once. It was the one thing from before the accident of which she was certain. The only part of her mother that remained was a piece of paper tucked away inside her pocket. Her mother had given it to her before she died. It didn't mean much of anything, but to the girl, it meant everything. She moved quickly through the dark forest, wishing she could fly like every other Strix, just a little bit further. She darted her head to the side mid-leap to see where the loud crack came from. It wasn't branches. It was the trunk of a tree that was now snapped in half and flying toward her. The Belcarra Keeper had found her. The sound of his thumping, thunderous footsteps thudded against the damp forest floor as he knocked down trees to clear his path. She needed to move faster, and she knew exactly where to go. The trees that surrounded her were covered in a secret code of her own making. Corey had taught her how to mark trees without catching the Keeper's attention when she was very young, so she could map the forest. She reached a cluster of hanging branches formed into the shape of dangling snowflakes. The snowflakes meant that she had entered a safe zone, an area where no other Strix had been found. She finally reached the edge of a rolling field of dandelions. Her treehouse pine was bent at the base and sat along the edge of the forest. It was marked with an X. She was almost home. but every leap, every step had to be careful and calculated. Two steps beyond her pine tree were dandelions sprawled toward a walled city with twinkling lights. There was an invisible barrier that she couldn't break through. She spent every night looking out at the city in the distance and wondering what life was like beyond the trees. She watched the morning fellows fly across the border and stomached the pain of knowing she couldn't go with them. Even if she wanted to touch the feathery dandelions, she couldn't. Lostrix were exiled from the outside world. She needed to be safest from other Strix, which was closest to exile. The young Strix wasn't just lost or stuck. She was trapped. It took many moons for her to accept her fate as a Lostrix of Belcara. The reality of her position struck the last time she saw Corey. It was a year ago, almost to the day, that he let out a blood-curdling, uncontrollable shriek. She knew what that meant. When a Strix screams, death always follows. A Strix's scream is a premonition, and it's never wrong. Neither of them could have possibly known, however, that the death he was foreshadowing was his own. He was flying above her, as he often did, but when the scream flew from his lips, he fell to the ground like a boulder tumbling from a mountaintop. A small twinkling yellow light escaped his mouth and floated through the trees. The girl looked at Corey, crumpled and pained on the forest floor. Her emerald green eyes, the size of pine cones, were wet with tears. She was unable to stop herself from trembling. The last time she'd heard a Strix scream, she had ended up with broken wings and without a mother. It'll be okay, he lied. Let's keep going. They made their way along the tree line to an overgrown village. While Corey marked the trees, the young Strix stepped toward a small house, which appeared abandoned and covered in moss. She had never been so close to a house in her life, and she was positive that she saw a pair of velvety red eyes looking back at her through the open curtains. Not that way, Corey warned. That's not Belcara. She stepped back toward the forest, but stopped when something hard and cold pressed into her back. She slowly turned and dragged her eyes up the towering figure. It was the Belcara keeper. Don't touch her! Corey lunged for the keeper and pushed the girl back into the trees. The girl hid behind the root of a tree. She met Corey's eyes moments before the keeper pushed him into the invisible barrier that lined the forest. The force of the violent throw shattered his body. 10 minutes after Corey's blood-curdling, uncontrollable shriek, he was gone. His needle-like feathers danced toward the ground like black snow. The girl stayed tangled in the roots of the tree for 3 days. Since then, she'd been all alone, and she didn't want her first run-in with another living being to be with the keeper. She knew he would end her without a thought in his head. After all, she wasn't supposed to be there. Nobody was. Though the forest was littered with Lostrix and countless other nefarious and dangerous creatures, everyone hid from the keeper. His heavy footsteps were all but gone when she reached her pine tree. She couldn't fly, but she was fast. Mist puffed with every strained breath as she darted up the crackling branches. Once she reached the roof of her treehouse, she scanned the forest. She could see the keeper pushing through the trees, but he was now running in another direction. Her eyes lifted to where the keeper was headed, which, as it turned out, wasn't for her. She focused on the horizon where the land met the ocean, and then the ocean met the fog. Through the thick black fog that surrounded the island from all directions, a smoking light appeared. When the light burned a hole through the fog, it vibrated and popped out a second light. Then that light too would float, burn, and multiply.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.